Hello, creative ladies and gents. Today I have a really simple transfer technique to show you. And I also want to show you a few other tips and tricks for mixed media on a budget. So what do you do if you do not have all the fancy products for mixed media? You work with what you do have. In this video I will show you that you can make a beautiful page with just a few things you find around your home. So start thinking outside of the box. We are creative people, right? So for the longest time I wanted to do a transfer of a magazine clipping, and I watched a few videos, but you also all needed stuff for that, and I didn't have that. So I wondered, can I do this with just only gesso? And yes, you can. I started by putting a coat of gesso on my page and putting down my image on there and burnish it with a credit card. Watch out that you do not rip the paper, and after that make sure it is completely dry. I did not have too much patience, so I dried it with my heat gun, and after it was dried I sprayed on some water and started rubbing off the paper. This is a work of a lot of patience, and you do have to be careful not to rub too hard, so you will rub off the ink of the image. And on the second page, that was what happened with me, but I think I either had my gesso too dry already when I put on my magazine clipping, or I didn't burnish enough because I ripped the paper at one point and I didn't want to rip more, so maybe I didn't burnish enough to get the transfer going. So when I'm done with the first side, I am drying it again in between, and you see that my image turns up white. That means there's another coat of paper on top of there, and it needs to be rubbed off. So the whole process starts again. I told you it takes a lot of patience, but I do love the end result, so it is absolutely worth it. So for the next step, I need you to think outside of the box and look around your house and find something to stencil with. I have a piece of disposable table runner that I got around Easter. And when you do not have modeling paste, you can look for something that will have the same effect. In my case, I use wall filler from The Action. That's a really cheap store in the Netherlands. but you could also use maybe gesso with sand in it, or white paint with sand in it. So I'm stenciling it all around my page. I also do a little transfer technique with some sort of glue. I used varnish for that. And I do that with my book paper. Not really that happy with the result, but it does work. And for the next step, I want to stamp something on my page. I came across a few pieces of wallpaper that I have in my stash. It's kind of with a foamy layer. I'm not sure how to explain it. I'll show you a few examples here. So I'm just inking up my piece of paper and then stamp it on my page. And for some extra pressure, I use an acrylic block. And you see the image is not as crisp, but that's just exactly what I wanted. The stamping is some extra interest. So it doesn't need to be really crisp. So that was for my stamping part, and then I have to finish my page, and I'm using the colors that are already in the picture. It had a bluish kind of tone in there, so I thought I would start with that. And I'm spraying my paper with water first a bit, because I also wanted to have a little bit of a dripping kind of technique, not too much. So I'm spraying a little bit more water because it was not enough to let it drip. And I also used my black and added water on that as well. And I now know it turns out more grayish. Then for the bottom, I did not want to do the spraying technique again because I didn't have that much room and I didn't want it to get over my picture. So I'm taking distress ink in peacock feathers, I think. Yes, in peacock feathers. And I'm doing the bottom with that. And I'm doing some more stamping with wallpaper. And then at last I'm rubbing over some eyeshadow. It's from a local store, Intense Color Eye Mousse, and it's waterproof, and I have a golden color that I'm rubbing over it. And then I'm also rubbing the same stuff in a different color on my image, because at some parts it was really white and I didn't like that really that much. So to blend it in with my paper, I rubbed on this eye mousse again, and I used two bluish colors, a bluish green and a blue one, dark blue one. And I also used a brownish one, and that kind of finishes off my page. I really love how this image turned out. It's really vintage. and I don't mind that half of it is gone. Actually, it adds to the vintage touch. So I'm overall really happy with how this page turned out, and maybe I add a quote later, but for now I just leave it like this because I do not have a great quote to use. Think outside the box when you're doing mixed media and just use what you have. Don't look at other people and see, oh, they have such beautiful stuff, so I never can make this. Just make it work with whatever you can find. So have fun, you guys, and I'll see you back with my next video.